If those who lead you say to you, "See, the kingdom is in the sky," then the birds of the sky will precede you. If they say to you, "It is in the sea," then the fish will precede you. Rather, the kingdom is inside of you, and it is outside of you. When you come to know yourselves, then you will become known, and you will realize that it is you who are the sons of the living Father. But if you will not know yourselves, you dwell in poverty, and this is you who are the poverty. Just a few days ago, scientists announced the discovery of the reason for the disappearance of the human tail. About 25 million years ago, due to a genetic mutation. In fact, Darwin was the first to discover the signs of a missing human tail in the anatomy. However, Darwin's theory of evolution, despite the strong evidence he had, remained only one theory. But if in his time science had reached the knowledge it has today of the constituent element of man, Darwin's name would have been immortalized otherwise. Science says that genetic mutation can be caused by copying errors in cell division and proliferation. It may also be caused by viruses or exposure to radiation, such as sunlight. In fact, all three are mysterious, especially cell errors. Why? Well, let's take a closer look to everything from the beginning, once and for all. Of course, I mean the building blocks of man and the world we know, not history or tradition. However, in this video you will see that they are related. But let's get ready for the main topic by giving an example. Genesis chapter 1 verse 6. And God said, "Let there be a vault between the waters to separate water from water." So God made the vault and separated the water under the vault from the water above it. God called the vault sky, and there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered to one place, and let dry ground appear." And it was so. God called the dry ground land, and the gathered waters he called seas. And God saw that it was good. Make no mistake, it did not mean that the place where you live right now is not spherical. There is an important issue. Note this, God records all the good and bad behaviors of everyone at every moment, and not even the slightest movement is hidden from his sight. No doubt you are all familiar with this or a similar sentence. You can understand the meaning of this sentence when once and for all examine everything closely from the beginning, so that you can understand the nature of human existence. But when you examine everything very closely and realize the nature of human existence, you will see that you are in fact acquainted with the nature of the universe and you will understand everything. But everything will have a different meaning for you if you learn a little bit of computer programming language in the meantime. So let's start from the beginning of life. Life is nothing but a chain of carbon atoms. Without carbon, life on Earth is impossible. And all this is the creation of the geometric technology of our world. based on carbon-12, and carbon-12 is an element of the structure of nature and our human body, which makes up 99% of all known forms of carbon. And this is a carbon isotope made of 6 protons, 6 neutrons, and 6 electrons. And in fact, this is the secret formula of creation, which is encrypted with the number 666. But what are protons, neutrons, and electrons? Studies have shown that our body is made up of organs. That is, the skin, the brain, the heart, the liver, and everything you know. Those organs are made of tissue. These tissues are made of cells. And cells are a very complex biological machine made up of three main parts: the cell membrane, the nucleus, and the cytoplasm. More study reveals that there are molecules deep inside the cells, that is, groups of atoms that are joined together by chemical forces. Atoms are a small, dense nucleus surrounded by electron clouds. Electrons are subatomic particles that revolve around the nucleus of an atom. They generally have a negative charge that balances the positive charge of the protons in the nucleus of the atom. Note that nuclei are about 1,000 times smaller than the atoms they contain. Imagine if the nucleus were the size of a candy, the atom would be about the size of a football field. If we lose all the empty space inside our atoms, each of us humans will be able to fit in a speck of dust, which means that the entire human race will fit in the sugar cube. The mass of an electron is about 1,000 times smaller than the mass of a proton. Electrons can also collide with other particles and scatter like light. Electrons are easily transferred from you to another person. To better understand this, wear a shoe with a plastic sole and touch another person. In the same way, each person's electromagnetic fields affect the other. But each nucleus is made up of two types of particles, protons and neutrons. But protons and neutrons are themselves a smaller set of other particles. These smaller particles bind tightly together. The smaller particles that make up protons and neutrons are called quarks, and scientists say quarks are strange. But why strange? Because there are a total of 6 types of quarks. Each of them has a different mass, and each of them interacts with the rest of the world in their own unique way. Did you get that? According to the researchers, the most famous of whom is James Gates, the behavior of quarks is governed by certain rules, and these rules are exactly the same as the code that is executed by internet browsers and search engines. So, by that logic, the laws governing the subatomic particles that make up us can actually be computer code. Just take one of the tissues of the human body under the microscope. To get excited about what you are seeing, millions of cells that are moving. You will no doubt ask, are these which are moving so fast a part of me? Yes, you are. But what causes those particles that we call molecules, cells, and atoms see as a body or an object? Well, at first it was thought that physics was about studying physical objects. That is, everything is reduced to particles. And that means everything you heard from the beginning of this video until now. An atom is the smallest possible piece of an element that retains all the properties of the element. For example, if you put two hydrogen atoms together, you get a molecule. If you add that hydrogen molecule to an oxygen atom, you create a water molecule. A molecule is a collection of atoms. So everything you see is matter, and the difference between the different states of matter is in the arrangement of the particles. And science has proved that 99.99% of a substance is empty space. And what makes up this empty space is energy. Yes, scientists believe that almost all of your body mass is from the kinetic energy of quarks. And the binding energy of the gluons is induced. It was in 1920 that with the discovery of quantum physics, we realized that everything is a matter of probability and not actually physical objects. And it wasn't long before John Wheeler discovered that at the core level, everything is information, everything is based on bytes. The idea is that everything we see physically is actually the product of lots of information. And this is exactly the kind of computer programming language. That is, we create a shape with computer code that you can see, and with a 3D printer we create it in your physical world, and you can touch it. We know that every living thing has DNA in the nucleus of the cell. The information in the DNA is encoded by four chemical bases: adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. Human DNA is made up of about 3 billion bases, and more than 99.9% of these bases are the same in all people. And there is only a 0.1% difference between human DNA, which represents millions of different places in the genome and causes diversity in living organisms. The order of these bases determines the information available to construct and maintain an entity, similar to how the letters of the alphabet appear in a particular order for the information of words and sentences. In short, using each person's DNA information, it is possible to make a copy of that person or part of that person. This rabbit was introduced to our world by a 3D printer designed by ETH researchers. This white rabbit is the first three-dimensional worm to contain DNA, and a 3D printer will be able to copy the rabbit with its DNA information over and over again. Now you are more familiar with yourself and the universe, and you have come to realize that our world is too much like a computer. In fact, my meaning of the universe is the universe I described, and we call it physical. Now note this. In programming, programmers ask the computer to check the condition by writing conditional statements. Conditional computer commands can make decisions. Conditional commands always have a section called if that tells the program what to do when the situation is true or false. For example, I write a program and say to check the messages section. And if you come across a word such as omit, show me the name and the details of the sender. Now if dozens of people send a message I never see, unless the message of who has used the word omit in the message. So, is it possible that we also have to look for keywords to send a message to the creator of this system we are inside right now? We should not be looking for keywords. Just be careful not to make mistakes. Why? Maybe this will help you. Do you know who invented the computer? An Englishman named Charles Babbage. If you go to the Ghost Club, a place in London that works on the supernatural, you will see a photo of the club's most proud member, Charles Babbage. And if you read his adolescent memoirs, it is said that he used various teachings to summon the devil. And it seems to be so.